thunder. We've always been, well, thunderstruck by it. But for a long time, we weren't sure what it was. The violent tantrum of a young god? The rumbling wheels of Thor's chariot? Or the flapping of a giant bird? It wasn't until we got a handle on the science of both storms and sounds that we figured out what thunder is and why it sounds the way, well, the many ways it does. Storms have a lot going on, and we'll take a rain check on explaining most of it. The key as far as thunder goes is that during a storm, positively and negatively charged particles build up in different places and then zigzag through the air to get rebalanced. During this rebalancing, which we know is lightning, a giant electrical current rushes through a tiny channel of air in a fraction of a second, instantaneously superheating the surrounding air. And since increasing air's temperature also increases its pressure, that air gets super pressurized, causing it to explode outward in what we call a shockwave. This sudden explosion is what we're experiencing when we hear a thunderclap. It's a distinct sound that seems to come out of nowhere and contains an incredible range of frequencies. Those same qualities are actually common to any abrupt and intense burst of pressure, from the bang of a supersonic jet, to the crack of a whip, to the pop of a balloon, to the snap of a tiny bolt of static electricity. That's why all shockwaves sound surprisingly similar, at least if you are nearby. As a shockwave travels through the air, it loses energy, and that intense burst of pressure smooths out. What's more, the wave's higher frequencies dissipate more quickly than its low frequencies. So the farther away you are from lightning, the less sudden the onset of the sound is, and the lower the sound sounds. Instead of a sharp clap, you might hear a resonant boom. Waves from more distant parts of the lightning bolt take even longer to reach you, and can overlap and echo off trees, hills, and clouds along the way. So you'll hear them as longer, even lower-pitched rumbles. And when lightning happens completely within a cloud, the waves start so far away and get so jumbled up that all you might hear is a soft rolling sound. Or nothing at all. Within a single storm, lots of waves of pressure from lots of different parts of lots of different lightning bolts intermingle and reach your ears at different times. So you'll often hear a symphony of claps, booms, rumbles, rolls, and more. It's a perfect storm of sound that launched a thousand origin and origin stories. I started working on this video because during a summer storm, it suddenly struck me that despite knowing a thing or two about science, I had no idea what thunder actually was. And if you have that same curiosity about the world around you, you'll love CuriosityStream, the sponsor of this video, which has tons of expertly curated shows about science, history, food, travel, and more for just $19.99 a year, less if you use our special promo code. I've been geeking out on nature's weirdest events, which explains the science behind the strangest stuff that happens on our planet, from blood-red skies to exploding toads. It's totally awesome. You can sign up at curiositystream.com/MinuteEarth and use code MinuteEarth to get a year-long subscription for just $15. And that also includes access to Nebula, which has exclusive content from your favorite educational YouTubers, like us. Thanks, CuriosityStream.